David's preliminary hearing's the day after tomorrow. Angela says I've got to be there.
Well, at least you get to see him, love, even though... Well, look, he did shoot Karen. He's not going to get off.
I know, but... Well, if Herbie testifies against David, it's going to affect my appeal.
Well, how come?
Herbie's going to tell him I saw Davey just after he escaped. I'll be had up for consorting, aiding and abetting, you name it. My appeal won't even go through.
Can he prove it?
It was Herbie took me to see David.
Oh. I think the governor's going to be quite so quick to trust you now, Coulson.
She never did nothing. I made her help. I said I'd break every bone in her body if
she
didn't
help. Shut up,
Lizzie. That's no way to speak to a lady.
No, you don't.
Let me go. Let go of me.
Come on.
Mr. Fletcher. He hit me, Mrs. Davidson. He hit me. Yeah, that's right. I saw him, Mrs. Davidson. He was like a wild thing, a real brute.
I'd never laid a finger on her.
I think we can believe our own eyes, Mr. Fletcher.
Quite obvious what happened.
Why would I want to hit anybody?
That's what we're attempting to find out.
Look, Mrs. Davidson, I've never hit a woman in my life. I'm hardly likely to start now, even with women like these.
Perhaps you would like to tell us what was going on. Because from where we were standing, it certainly looked as though you'd hit her.
You both know damn well that I've never hit a woman.
That's what your friend claimed before he bashed Meg.
Listen,
that's
Vera.
That's enough. Both of you.
I'm sorry.
I'm still waiting for an explanation. Both Miss Bennet and I saw you raise your arm to Coulson, and we both heard her cry out.
She was pretending.
Pretending?
Look, I walked in and I caught them both red-handed. She probably only did it to try and draw attention away from the fact that she was stealing. Look, Mrs. Davidson, I swear I never hit her. She probably got it into her head that if she could convince you that I'd clobbered her, you'd be more lenient on her for knocking over the kitchen.
Bring her in. How's that?
Dunno. Can't see a thing. Dunno that that'll work. Best thing is if I give you a fair dinkum whack across the face. That'll mark it for sure.
Okay.
Oh, flies are bad.
I might have known. You better change your tune, Coulson. Unless you want to be charged with making false accusations against an officer, as well as theft.
I don't know what you mean.
Inside. Not you, Birdsworth.
I'd love to know what's keeping them. They should have been back ages ago. If you've shopped them, your life's not going to be worth two bob.
I never.
Oh, no, I bet.
Oh, look, Bea, I'm not likely to do anything like that now, am I?
Well, I wouldn't put it past you.
Oh, you can think what you like. All I'm telling you
and
is
I'm telling you. One of these dark nights, you're going to wake up with a mouthful of knuckle sandwich.
Oh, leave her alone, Bea.
I'm not touching her.
I mean, just lay off.
Good, how much is it going to take before you wake up to that bitch?
Well, I know what she's like. She shot me too, remember? But as long as she's pregnant, you leave her alone.
And you can take that stupid grin off your face. Knocking a few of your teeth out isn't going to hurt the kid none.
I mean, there was no explanation, no warning, nothing. He just waded in and belted me.
Do you seriously expect me to believe that Officer Bennet is lying too? You still have time to change your story, but I might as well remind you that the charge of stealing is sufficient to put you straight back into solitary. And be warned, I have no tendency whatsoever to sympathy. I have put my faith in you and you've betrayed that trust. Bring in Birdsworth.
Lizzie will back me up.
Oh, yes, I'm sure she will. And if she does, She too will be charged with laying false accusations against an officer, which is a very serious offense.
He didn't hit me, he just...
Go on.
Look, it had nothing to do with Lizzie, Mrs. Davidson. It was my idea. It was a sort of spur-of-the-moment thing, you know. The thieving was too, that was my idea. Lizzie had nothing to do with it.
Pigs, bum, I was in it up to here. Matter of fact, it was all my idea.
I suppose it was your idea that Mr. Fletcher hit Coulson too.
No, that was real. He hit her all right. Thumped your beauty, didn't he, Roz?
No, he didn't.
Oh? Didn't he? I would have swore he'd hit her.
Would you just?
Yes.
Owing to your state of health, I will not be placing you in solitary confinement. But you will be confined to your cell except for work and meal breaks. You will also be without buy-up privileges until further notice. Take her away, Mr. Fletcher.
I know me way. Don't you put your hands on me. Oh, he's a violent man, Mrs. Davidson.
Come on,
it's
Lizzie.
It's no good for me old ticker being knocked about.
2 days solitary confinement. You will be charged with theft, and the visiting justice will hear the charge. Understand?
Yes.
And think yourself lucky you dropped your accusation against Mr. Fletcher. Take her away.
Mrs. Davidson,
I do not want to hear it. I am sick to death of your continual abuse of my faith in you. Now get out!
Go on, hurry up, get your meal. As soon as Birdsworth's finished a meal, she's to be taken back and locked in the cell.
What's up?
She's to be confined until further notice.
Well, how long's that?
Not much of a last meal. Not before time. Where the bloody hell have you been?
We got lumbered.
Where's Ross? I don't know, in Saltry, I suppose.
Oh, God, now, what happened? Either Fletch stumbled on it or we got shopped. What do you reckon, Chrissy?
Well, how would I know?
Oh, now, don't you two start. At least you got off, you see.
Off? Pigs, I got off. I'm confined to me bloody cell as soon as I finish this muck. And they've stopped me buy up.
Oh.
Well, what do you reckon now, Chrissy?
Just a minute, Latham. What the hell are you doing here?
Miss Bennett's orders.
Is that a fact?
Oh, yeah. Wake up to yourself, Fletch. What pays better, the laundry or the maternity wing?
Yeah, and who's been making up to Miss Bennett? Yeah.
That's enough out of you, Birdsworth.
Just so you know about it, Fletch.
All right, Latham, on your feet. You're going back to the maternity wing and staying there.
You...
No! Unless you want to be put on report as well. Come on.
You wanted to see me?
Yes, the new social worker, Paul Reed, is arriving tomorrow. Make sure Jean Vernon's office is ready for him.
Even though I'm not a member of the domestic staff, I'll see that the order is carried out.
Furthermore, do not continue with this ridiculous attempt to, how shall I put it? Liaise with Chrissy Latham.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Good, because I still remember the disasters caused by your liaison with my niece.
Is that all?
Not quite. I will not tolerate any further insinuations about Jim Fletcher's supposed tendency towards violence from the inmates nor from my staff.
But, Mrs.
That will be all, Miss Bennett.
Sit down, Pat. Hey, something down's not going to do any good.
Nothing is. What are you doing dressed so early?
I'm waiting for the paddy wagon. David's preliminary hearing's due today.
Oh, yeah.
Cheer up. Everything might turn out all right.
Oh, how can it? Whatever happens, he's going to spend the rest of his life in jail. And once Herbie gets up in the stand, then I've had it too.
Look, you don't know that. He might keep his mouth shut. Well, he's Dave's mate, isn't he?
Some mate. He turned him into the cops.
Isn't that what you wanted? Probably saved his life.
Oh, where's that paddy wagon?
Don't worry, it won't be going without you.
Wish I could get out just for a day. Stuck here in me cell.
And whose fault's that?
Hey, where's that note you're going to smuggle out to Herbie?
In my locker.
Well, why not take it with you? You might be able to slip it to him in court.